Going off to college is an exciting time for students, but before they head out on their own, it's important they understand how to manage their money. Financial professional Kevin Klug from Secure Retirement Solutions is here with four topics to cover before your student heads off to college. And my student, Kevin, is 8 months and I'm already starting to think about that.
That's perfect, perfect timing.
But that's the thing, you have to think about it now.
You do. Unfortunately, money management isn't typically taught in schools nowadays. So.
And why is that?
It's up to the parents. The parents need to get involved. It's not part of any state mandated tests either. In fact, Wisconsin received an F in a recent report on ranging on how to gauge states on how they teach financial literacy. So it's important to get started and do it at home.
What should these college freshmen then know about money?
You want to start building good credit right away, so when you have to lease that apartment or buy that car, you have some credit established. But understand the difference between establishing good credit and overextending yourself. So I have five or four key points that will help get you started and build a good foundation.
And what are those key points?
First one would be a budget. So you want to create a budget, even though you maybe don't have income coming in throughout the year, the school year, but you want to track your expenses. Mm-hmm. So track your expenses, everything from books to trips back home and even Christmas gifts. You want to have that all on a sheet, and if you don't have a budget worksheet, go to my website at srsplans.com and you can download a budget worksheet to help get you started.
Okay, what's the next one then?
The next one is going to be a checking and savings account. So if your student's heading off to college, you want to make sure they have a checking and savings account. And you maybe go online and help them track the totals so that way they don't get hit with a fee for overdraft or bouncing a check or something like that. Also make sure the bank is on or near the campus that your child's attending, so if they need to access their ATM card, they don't get hit with a fee.
People are telling me to open a savings account right now for my daughter, and it slips my mind, but it is really important.
It's important to start early, definitely.
And what's the other point then?
The next one, number three, would be a credit card. So if you're gonna, you know, set your child up with a credit card.
Is that scary?
It is. You wanna be disciplined though. You wanna teach them how to handle it. But use one that has a low annual percentage rate, a grace period for making payments, low fees, and no annual fee. And often when people get a credit card, they wanna buy things that they can't afford. But you have to be disciplined and only buy the things that you need that you can pay back each and every month.
Do you think some students think it's almost like free money?
They do, because they don't quite understand it yet, but you have to help them and teach them to be disciplined. Keep track of that payment date too. So that way, you know, you don't skip a payment or miss a payment that can hurt your credit in the future.
All right, what about the last point then?
Last one, student loans. You don't have to take the full amount that's offered, just use what you need. That's sometimes unfortunate when you take too much more than you can handle.
Yeah.
Also, you don't have to make payments typically until after graduation, so you can wait, but if you can make interest payments that accrue, that'd be a good start and a jump start after you graduate.
Some really good tips, some I wish I knew about before I had gone off to college. You live and you learn, right?
You do, you have to.
Let's talk about after graduation though. Yeah. You know, you're thinking about heading into the workforce.
Right.
What tips do you have?
You want to start like you are early and often. You want to start saving early. You want to start, a recent report said that recent 2015 graduates won't be able to retire until age 75. So that's important, start early.
That's a scary word for some people, and something I think a lot of students might not think about. I know I really didn't think about it until I started my quote-unquote career, retirement, looking into that. I mean, that's another thing to start thinking about,
it is.
Too.
We had a recent young graduate just come through our office. He wanted to start making a contribution on the month he turned 18. That's what it's going to take for the young adults to get going. We don't know what Social Security is going to be like in 40, 50 years for these young adults, so you have to take control yourself.
Do you think parents are scared to talk to their kids about it, or just it's really not on their mind right
now? It's not on their mind, I think. And I try to, at home, try to be involved and teach the value of money. And even at 5 and 9 years old, our daughter is really trying to teach them the value of money, how to save up for things that they want. So it starts at home, it has to, and it's maybe just something you have to fit into your daily schedule.
And start when they're young.
Start when they're young.
Kevin Klug, thank you for being with us this morning.
Thanks,
we have all of the information posted on our website at fox11online.com. Really something to start thinking about.